Welcoming you all. Today let's see how to prepare a homemade herbal bath powder. I have taken about half a kg of Bengal gram dal. So wash the Bengal gram dal well, drain the water completely and sun dry it in a cotton cloth. If you don't wash the Bengal gram dal, then there may be some itching in the body. So make sure that you wash it and dry it well. So this gives you a nice smooth and brightens the skin. So make sure that you wash the Bengal gram dal and the green moong dal as well. I have taken about 1/4 kg of green moong dal or passipayaru. So this green moong dal is rich in vitamin A and C, which gives you a healthy glow to your skin, and it acts as a scrub and helps in removing the dead skin cells. It brightens the skin and helps in retaining the moisture of the skin and prevents acne and pimples. I have taken about 1/4 kg of rose petals. So all the ingredients that I am using in this herbal bath powder is available in the local country medical store known as the Nattu Marundhu Kadai. You can use fresh panneer rose flowers. Remove the petals, wash them well, and you can sun dry it. So these rose petals are rich source of vitamin C, which acts as a sunblock. So the cooling properties of these rose petals soothes the skin and protects it from all kinds of sun damages, and it prevents acne and pimple and helps in retaining the moisture of the skin, and it gives you a very soft and glowing skin. So sweet flag, also known as vasambu, I have taken about 15 grams of it. So this sweet flag plays a major role in the all the South Indian households where there are newborn babies. So this sweet flag are mostly tied as a bangle to the newborn baby. So when they inhale or smell it, it will prevent the vomiting sensation in the kids. So I have taken only about 15 to 20 grams of it, not more than that. It helps in removing the unwanted facial hairs, and it is also used in treating pimple and pimple related scars. So you can use it even for your babies, no problem in it. So I have taken about 1/4 kg of kasturi manjal or wild turmeric. So this is wild turmeric, and this one is poolan kilangu or white turmeric. So this wild turmeric whitens and brightens the skin, and it has antiseptic and antibacterial properties. And the main purpose of this kasturi manjal is to remove the unwanted facial hair, and it is used in the treatment of acne and acne related scars, and it gives you a blemish free skin. I've taken about 1/4 kg of white turmeric. White turmeric helps in healing any damage in the skin, and it also prevents skin infection. So when this white turmeric is used along with the wild turmeric, acts as an antiseptic and a body scrub. It gives you a good glow to the skin. Both the wild turmeric and white turmeric gives you a nice odor. So 1/4 kg of Tanner's Cassia or Avarampu. So this Tanner's Cassia is also available in the local country medical store. If you want it to be fresh, then during this festival season of Pongal, this flower is abundantly available in the market. So you can buy it from the market, remove the flowers, clean them well and dry it in the sun. So it treats various skin problems. It prevents skin infections, black spots, and even the uneven skin tone which is caused by the sun rays. And the regular use of this Tanner Cassia gives you a blemish free skin, and it gives you a very good aroma and acts as a natural coolant to your body. This is known as nut grass. I have taken 15 grams of it. It's known as korai kilangu in Tamil and nagar mota in Hindi. So it prevents skin infection and the body odor that's caused by sweat. And when this nut grass is used along with white turmeric, it removes the unwanted facial hairs. It is used in treating various skin related diseases like scabies, eczema, and relieves itching. So now mix all the ingredients well. So I have already dried all the ingredients in the sun well. So now I am mixing all the ingredients together. So along with this ingredients, I am going to add about 2 tablespoons of methi seeds or fenugreek seeds. So don't worry, you won't get any aroma of this methi seeds. The methi seeds, when we soak it in the water, it turns out like a gel. So which helps in retaining the moisture of the skin and also soothes the skin. Sometimes we get like white patches in the skin due to dryness. So adding methi seeds, you won't get anything. So now we are going to grind it into a nice and fine powder. So once it's been powdered, I'll show you. So our homemade herbal bath powder is ready. Yes, you're getting a nice and good aroma of it. I'm taking about 1 teaspoon of this prepared herbal powder and mixing it with 1/2 teaspoon of curd. So you can either use curd, raw milk or rose water, or you can use the fresh water for preparing this bath powder. So mix it well. So many, they ask me like, we have used your bath powder but we are getting some kind of itching and all those things. So make sure that whenever you use a homemade herbal bath powder, make sure that you at least soak it for about 30 minutes before using it. So for the boy babies who are less than 12 years, you can use the same powder. For those above 12 years, skip this wild turmeric, that is the kasturi manjal, and you can use it. This powder can be stored in the refrigerator for about 6 months. We have sun dried and washed every ingredient, so you can store it in the refrigerator for 6 months. So after 1/2 hour, if you see, our mixture is nice and thick. It has been soaked well. For dry skin people, you can apply either olive oil or almond oil before using this bath powder mix. So now, as you can see, after 1/2 hour, it has turned out nice and thick. So when we apply it on our skin, it won't leave any traces of the yellow color. So anyone can use it on all days. You can use it. There will be no traces of yellow color on your skin. Try out this simple homemade herbal bath powder for a healthy glowing skin and let us know your feedback. If you like our video, like, share and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.